Hi yogis, Carlene Rose here, and welcome to a Nerdy Yogi YouTube channel. Today we are going to be doing a bit more of a chill pigeon pose flow. We will start with a little bit of a warm-up, but mostly it's going to be stretching, so if you've done a little bit of yoga practice before, that's totally fine because it'll be super warmed up. Like I said, we're going to do just a little bit to warm up the muscles, just in case you haven't already. So we'll start in a mountain pose near the back of our mat. We'll start by inhaling, arms reach up, exhale, bend everything, bend your knees as you fold close to the earth. Now we want to come just to our first edge of stretch here. So finding whatever that edge is for you, knees are probably going to be a little bit bent to start, which is totally fine, especially if you've, you know, just started your practice. Now from here, we'll inhale, wave the spine forward, exhale, folding back down, inhale, wave. Exhale, one more wave here, and exhale. Now from here, bending really close to the earth, we are going to walk our hands out into a plank pose. And from here, coming onto our knees, lowering through our chaturanga, we're going to inhale here, prepare, wave our spine long, and we're just going to roll in and up to maybe baby cobra. Exhale back down, inhale, waving in and up, exhale, one more time, inhale, waving in and up, and exhale. Now this time we're going to inhale up and come through our pointed plank into our down dog. Inhale here, prepare, we're going to ninjasana style this one, so walk your hands back. Coming onto your fingertips just till you get to that first moment where your weight is back onto your heels. And then you'll bend your knees. Inhale, wave your spine halfway tall. Inhale, here, prepare. Exhale, unfurl yourself to the sky, back to stand. And exhale, hands back to heart center. So a little getting the blood moving, getting the energy flowing a little bit. Inhale, here, exhale. Inhale, we're going to come back down, bending our knees back to our forward fold. Inhale, wave. Exhale. Inhale, wave. Exhale. Really using the bent limbs, this waving-like motion to get the energy moving, give yourself good power, and keep yourself in good alignment. And then from here, with bent legs, walk yourself out into a plank, unrolling there. Come onto your knees. We're again keeping good shoulder health and alignment when we do that. Lowering to the earth. Wave up. Exhale. As we do these waves, really think about zipping in and up through your front spine. Extending through the crown. Exhale. And this time, coming up through pointed plank to down dog. All right, now this time we're gonna inhale, bend just a little bit to the earth, right leg lifts to the sky. We'll start by opening our hips and letting the foot fall behind us. Starting to get a stretch in our psoas, opening the front of our hips. All right, now leg extends as you square your hips back to the earth. We're going to exhale, bend the knee and the elbows, and bring the right elbow or right knee to the right elbow. Inhale up. Exhale, twist to the left arm this time. Inhale up. Exhale to the upper right arm. Inhale up. Exhale, twist. Inhale back up, and then this time, core plank to the center, and drop your right knee behind your right wrist. All right, pigeon pose. A lot of people don't like this pose because we store a lot of tension in our hips, a lot of stress in our hips. So to work that out can sometimes be an emotional journey for people. And if that is you, just means you need to do it a little more, which is totally fine. If this is outside of your range of flexibility right now, you can get a block, get a pillow. You can also do this on your back and just hold your knee towards your chest if that's easier for you. But we'll come into pigeon. In pigeon pose, we want our hips to be square. You don't want to be rolling onto one side or the other. Your back leg is extended out behind you in as much of a straight line. So again, you don't want your leg wigging out one way or the other. So just straight behind you, and then your front knee does not need to be parallel to the front of your mat, anything like that. You also don't want to flex your foot in this position. You actually want to keep more of a, not a totally pointed foot, but a neutral foot, because you don't want, with flexing your foot, you torque your knee. You don't want to torque your knee. So you want your knee and your ankle to roll naturally onto the earth. So now that we have good alignment, we're going to inhale here, wave up. So this stretch, we're going to get into our hip flexor a little bit. We'll do some waving pigeons, so waving down to the earth. Inhale here, wave up. As you lift up, press into the earth, press away from the earth here. So we're going to work the muscles that we're stretching that will help them stretch and open faster. Release that as you wave down. Wave up again. Exhale. And then this time, we're not going to press up. We'll just walk our hands back a bit. Get a little deeper into the hip flexor stretch right here. Like I said, we're also getting into our psoas muscle, which is great because that's really the only muscle that connects our legs directly to our spine, which is awesome. Exhale. Now from here, walk yourself out long when you do this fold and find that first edge of stretch. If you're up here, if you need a block, maybe some books, whatever the case may be, just hang out on your hands. Maybe you come to your elbows. Maybe you rest fully on the floor, whatever that edge of stretch is for you. And it can vary day to day, it can vary side to side. You just have to find where you are in the moment right now. So kind of find that stretch, and we'll do some mini waves with the spine. Perfect. And now we're going to take our left arm, put it across this way on our mat, so parallel to the top of our mat, parallel to our knee. We're going to twist over towards the right side. Again, wave the spine long. You want to make sure you have a nice long spine as you're doing this. You can cup your right hip and make sure that your right hip is still grounded towards the earth, that you're not like coming up anything crazy like that. Nice long spine. From here, you can do a half bind if that feels good to you. You can look towards the earth if that feels good on your neck, forward, up, whatever's easiest. And you can stay here for a few more breaths, or if you are feeling it, you can reach for the back foot and bring the back foot towards you to get into the quad on the left leg. Again, making sure that you're not rolling too much onto one side or the other. Release that, making your way back, grounding into the earth here, into your downward dog. Pedal out the feet. Notice that difference you've made on that right side. You can lift the right leg up, drop it behind you again, and just let it shake. Shake it out. Kind of a rain stick movement if you want. Let all that energy move through the body. This time we are going to bend everything close to the earth, and we'll wave ourselves forward to plank, coming onto our knees, lowering through our chaturanga. Inhale here, we'll do those waves. You can come up a little bit higher on your cobra. One last time. And then this time, as we roll ourselves in and up, press back to our down dog. Ninjasana style it again. So on your fingertips, walk yourself back till you have weight on your feet and your heels. Bending your knees here. Wave your spine long, coming halfway up. Inhale here, prepare, bending the knees a little again and rolling yourself, unfurling to the sky. Exhale. exhale, hands come to heart center, namaste. Whew, just notice how that feels, you know, how the energy is on one side versus the other, but thankfully we have two legs, so we get to do all of that again. So inhale up, exhale, coming onto the earth. Walk yourself forward into your plank, lowering onto the knees, lowering through your chaturanga. Inhale, prepare. Exhale, rolling in and up. And again, you can come up higher now that we've gotten more warmed up. On this last one, we're going to come up through our pointed plank into down dog. Bend our knees and elbows just a little. Use that power to lift the left leg high this time. Start by opening the hips to the side, letting the left knee fall behind you. Starting the stretch here. Then squaring off the hips as you extend the left leg again. Inhale here, exhale. Left elbow to upper left arm. Inhale up. Exhale, twist to the right. Inhale up. Exhale, comes to the left upper arm again. Inhale up, twist to the right, last time. Inhale, leg extends up, and exhale to the center, and left knee comes behind left wrist. Make your way back into pigeon. And again, roll yourself around, find where that good alignment is. You might notice that you're tighter on one side than you are on the other, which is totally fine. But again, you might notice it's different day to day. The important thing is building the alignment and just finding your edge of stretch wherever you are on the spectrum. We'll start with our pigeon wave. So inhale, lifting up. Remember to press into the earth. So we're lifting up a little bit off the ground, activating those muscles, and then exhale, waving forward. Inhale up. Exhale, inhale up, pressing into the earth, exhale. That helps us stretch faster when we use those muscles too. Now this time just walk your hands back, feeling that hip flexor stretch, making sure again that your hips are aligned, they're squared off, you're not sitting on one side. It's not really going to help you stretch if you are doing that. And then walk yourself forward. So come forward first, long spine. You don't want to hunch over your leg to get down any certain length or anything. So long spine, then walk yourself out wherever the stretch is. And don't judge yourself when you're in these poses. You're stretching, you're releasing tension, you're releasing energy, you're building strength and flexibility. There's no reason to say, oh, I've got a good side or a bad side, or I can't do this, whatever the case may be. There's a whole spectrum of where you can play within the pose, so find what that is for you and just be there. Be in that moment and just feel where the stretch is and be really present to it. That's really all you gotta do when you're doing this. So get some mini waves in the spine, finding that area of good stretch for you where you are aligned and you're feeling the work. Not judging yourself or criticizing yourself for where your body's at, because that makes no sense. And then from here, right arm's going to come across you on the ground. We're going to twist, remembering to, you can even horseshoe the left hip to give you a good reminder to keep that hip grounded towards the earth so you're not rocking one way or the other. And you want to make sure that the right hip is still grounded onto the earth as well. Really feeling that twist as you stretch, and then from here, you can do a half bind, so rotate the palm behind you, get that good rotation, then come into the arm bind. And find a comfortable position for your neck, whatever that may be for you. And we're holding this pose for a long time, because you really want to hold the stretch for probably about 90 seconds to make changes. If you hold the stretch for, you know, 5 seconds, it's not really going to do a lot. So that's why in yoga we go through the same poses, and in this case we're holding the stretch a little bit more in depth to actually transform your body. And then if you want the extra challenge, reach for the foot and bring your foot towards your body, getting into your quad. If you need a strap or a towel in order to do this, if your foot's really far away, you can totally do that too. Again, we're playing on our spectrum and, you know, building our poses. Perfect. From here, release that. Ooh, feels so good. Ground into the earth with your fingertips. Walk yourself back up to down dog. Pedal out the feet. Letting that energy or that prana move through your body. Left leg lifts again. Twist the hips and shake out the leg. Awesome. And bring the left foot back to the earth. Inhale here, prepare. Roll yourself forward, coming onto your knees through chaturanga. Inhale, prepare. Roll yourself in and up. Exhale. And those cobra waves. And last one lifts you up through pointed plank to your down dog. Awesome. One last ninjasana. So coming onto your fingertips, walking yourself back so you have weight in the heels. Bending your knees here. Inhale. Long spine. You come halfway up. Bend the knees here. Unroll yourself to the sky. Exhale. Hands back to heart center. Namaste. Awesome. And then from here, just walk yourself out onto the mat. We're going to come into a Shavasana, our final resting pose. Let all of that energy that we just released and moved through our body, just let that settle and transform us, kind of make a new you for the rest of the day. I really hope you enjoyed that practice. I really hope you continue to do that practice. Stretching out your hips is so, so good for you. I love pigeon. It's one of my favorite poses. I know a lot of people are not that into it, but it's probably because you need to do it more. So do it. Have fun with it. Find your spectrum for the pigeon pose. I look forward to seeing you on the mat next time. Make sure you are subscribed to the YouTube channel. That way you'll get a notification for the next flow. Also, of course, the VIP email list for exclusive content. I look forward to seeing you there. Namaste.